Soulfish was basically a brand that was created under the activity that we were doing at the time. You know, we were in Scotland. You know, the UK sort of doesn't really, at that time, didn't really endorse, you know, your hip-hop culture that much. So, I mean, we were into, you know, the hip-hop. We were on that conscious hip-hop, Talib Kweli, Mos Def, and all that. And as such, we felt the need to look the part. So we decided, I need to have a Rockaway shirt. I need to have a Fed Farm, you know, jean, you know, or have a Jordan Snicker. And those things were hard to come by in Scotland. Actually, they were very expensive. So one of our business partners, who became a business partner at the time, was in the States. So, you know, managed to get a situation where he basically shipped clothing for us. And yeah, we were looking fresh, but we decided, I mean, he could be shipping clothes every day, but we wanted to now sell the clothes in the UK because we felt the gap. We saw the gap in people that actually enjoyed hip hop and the look, how they looked. So I guess that was the birth of So Fresh, because at that point we decided, if Rockaway can do it, if Fed Farm can do it, why can't we do it for the Swazi people? And, you know, it basically spanned from that. And coming back home, we decided, you know, the fashion industry in Swaziland was not that, you know, rife, if I may say. So we basically saw some of the biggest, you know, brands, or rather maybe fashion designers, not getting the full coverage because they were probably specific to a certain market, you know, designing gowns, designing, you know, cocktail type, you know, wear. And we thought, you know, if we could take these designers and give them a look that would sell in the streets, that would give them the edge that even your younger generation could identify with those designers, then it probably would make sense. So we decided to craft the So Fresh brand, and that's where So Fresh was sort of born. So Fresh, the clothing label, because So Fresh is actually a concept. It's a huge concept beyond the clothing. So, you know, Emo and I sat down and, you know, looked at what was hot at the time, and we basically decided, nah, this is about defining us. So we call it Swazi Origin Fresh because we wanted to define us and what we do. So this was not really to promote clothing by So Fresh really, but it was to promote designers and actually allow that gateway to open for young designers coming up. So what we then decided to do is hook up with your well-known designers in Swaziland, like the likes of Chanks, the likes of Spalele, and say, guys, look, design a line for So Fresh, put it out there. And because you already have that sort of, you know, clout, everyone knows about Spalele, but they haven't seen Spalele on the streets, or they know about Chanks, they haven't seen Chanks on the streets. Let's have something that you can design for the streets, for your 18-year-old, for your 25-year-old, something that the youth, you know, you know, make them feel so fresh in a Spalele design. And that, in turn, then, when we rotate those designers, meant that we can introduce newer designers into the market, people that are doing beautiful work, you know, but are not really known, you know. So that's where So Fresh came from. So we are still, you know, on course with that. And, you know, the lines keep coming out, you know, beautiful designs. And it's beautiful to see Swazis actually take on the brand and understand that we are not just sort of pushing a clothing label, but we are pushing a culture of what's fresh about being Swazi. So this is not just about the clothing, but the music, you know, and the crafts and all of that. We basically wanted to enshrine it into one label that we called So Fresh and present it to the Swazi people and the world entirely. So I think that's the long and short of what So Fresh is, what Swazi Origin Fresh is. And it's been beautiful. Our artist put it out there, Claiming Ground. Basically, we used Claiming Ground as the engine to basically put it out there. You know, MO goes on stage, looking so fresh.
So fresh.
And it's beautiful. It's beautiful to see, you know, the demand for it. But ultimately as well, it was a brand that we wanted to keep exclusive, you know. So that when you owned it, it wasn't to say, hey, I have another T-shirt written so fresh, but I have something that I'm proud of. I am in my So Fresh gear, but I'm bumping my Swazi music, and I'm basically representing me, you know. So we've now got to a point where we endorse a lot of brands. I mean, you know, brands have been coming up, brands that were there before So Fresh, like the likes of Skonian Republic, you know, the likes of Mezzo. I mean, those are brands that we've seen coming up, but we endorse them. I mean, right now I'm rocking a Roots cap, SD cap, beautiful, designed by one of our DJs, actually, DJ Stitch. So these are the products that you'll be seeing coming out of Swaziland, and of course the quality improves, and the idea is to take it further. Yeah. So yeah, that's the long and short of So Fresh, the brand. Yeah.
CG.
Yeah.
In case you didn't know, I'm just wondering.
She make me happier than somebody who just won the lottery. This girl is always in my heart like an artery. Charge me up like a battery. Love my flattery. Cut me.